Hi everyone! So this week I'm talking through 5 vitamins and minerals to help you through your period. So I find this area really fascinating. Obviously the vitamins and minerals are my area of expertise, but particularly for women with PMS or who are still having periods, I find it really interesting how different minerals can help us through. So this applies to women whether or not they're on hormonal contraceptives. So the hormonal contraceptives is a really interesting one because there is actually research to suggest that being on the hormonal contraceptives such as the pill can actually deplete our levels of vitamins and minerals. Then we have the other side of the story, so women who aren't on the pill, for example, but are still struggling with monthly symptoms and are considering if vitamins and minerals might actually help them to manage some of their symptoms. So in some cases, a little bit of hormone imbalance might be underlying, and that's when a remedy such as your Agnus Castus might actually be useful. But for others who have fairly balanced hormones and aren't needing to influence their hormones as such, but are still getting symptoms, sometimes it could be linked to nutrient deficiencies, so vitamin and mineral deficiencies. So for that reason, I'm just going to talk through my list of top nutrients that can hopefully help to make a difference for many of you. So my first nutrient is a mineral, and that is magnesium. So this is just one of my all-time favourite nutrients, as I'm sure you'll learn from watching my videos, but it is particularly relevant for women who are experiencing PMS or symptoms around the time of their period. First of all, magnesium is very affected by the pill, so if you're on the pill, your levels of magnesium could be potentially lower, as well as just all the normal reasons for it being low, such as stress, and just not eating enough of those lovely fresh food options. Magnesium is wonderful because it really helps to target both the physical and the psychological or emotional symptoms of PMS and those kind of related monthly symptoms. So it's a muscle relaxant, so it's very good for helping to calm the muscles in and around the womb for people who struggle with cramps, but also it's very calming psychologically and has positive effects on our mood as well. So for that reason, I find it super, super beneficial. And again, just because so many people are at risk of deficiencies. It is obviously good to fill up on your food sources primarily, and then the supplement can come in to be the kind of top up option. So magnesium is found in lovely fresh foods, so lots of your nuts and seeds, your whole grains, rice, as well as all your fruit and vegetables. So it is quite prevalent, but we really need to be eating your fresh foods. And in terms of supplement doses, we would be looking for between 200 to 400 milligrams at the top end, but around the 200 mark potentially for most people, especially if you're taking it in a multi with other nutrients, the levels might not be quite so high. Next on my list is iron. And iron is particularly important for women who have historically had quite heavy periods. We lose iron each month when we're bleeding, so it might just be that those people are slightly more likely to be deficient, potentially vegetarians as well, although there, of course there are good vegetarian options of iron as well, but those groups of people might just be a little bit more aware of it. So as I say, we can lose iron each month, so it's important to replenish it in our diet. We have iron in lots of your leafy greens, vegetables, and then lots of your whole grains such as your beans and seeds again. But of course, if we have particularly heavy periods or we feel our diet is lacking a little bit, then again, that's when the supplement comes in. Conventional iron supplements can potentially cause or give rise to constipation, so I tend to recommend a nice natural option such as your Salus House Floridix Iron. It's a lovely liquid formula, it's a nice form that's well absorbed, and yeah, it's one I quite often recommend if people are looking to try a little supplement out and see how you feel. Next on my list is zinc. Again, unfortunately, it is a mineral which can be affected by the pill. You might be more likely to be deficient. And zinc is really important for helping to manage the production of our sex hormones. So it's really important for a lot of kind of key chemical reactions and different enzymes and the production of both estrogen and progesterone. So it's something we do need enough of. There is also some research, which again I will tag in the description for all the research that I'm mentioning, that it could potentially help with some of the cramps that we experience. And that's because zinc is thought to have some anti-inflammatory potential as well. Zinc is really prevalent in seafood, and then veggie options would be your nuts and seeds. So seafood and meat really for your non-vegetarians, and then all your nuts and seeds are really dense in zinc for the vegetarians. Next on my list, although it's not a vitamin or a mineral, I cannot not mention it because it's in my top list for sure, and that's your omega-3. There's so much research again around this. It's super, super anti-inflammatory, and for that reason it can help to target those pro-inflammatory prostaglandins, which give rise to all those uncomfortable cramps that we can experience, particularly in the first few days of our period. So it's really one that I would consider. Again, dietary sources, if we can, that would be in your oily fish, and then for vegetarians it would be your walnuts, your flaxseed, and also flaxseed oil is a lovely one to drizzle over salads and cooked foods. We just wouldn't use flaxseed oil in the actual cooking process. It should just be for drizzling. And then obviously you can get your supplements as well. So you can get your capsules of either your flaxseed oil and also your fish oil or your cod liver oil. Personally, I would go for the fish oil over the cod liver. Potentially it's just a little bit cleaner. But your flaxseed oil is a perfect vegetarian alternative. Last one on my list for today is B vitamins. Once again, unfortunately, it is one that has been shown to be depleted as a result of the pill. We're more likely to excrete more of the B vitamins if we're on medication. The B vitamins are water soluble, so we can't really store them as well, and they are quite easily excreted, but more so if we are on medications. B vitamins are so important for a number of functions, which may come under fire as our hormones drop and we become a bit more vulnerable around that time of the month. So for fatigue, for example, B vitamins help to convert our food into energy. So a deficiency could mean that we're a little bit lacking in energy and experiencing some fatigue and tiredness. They're also really important for helping to maintain the functions of our nervous system. So that's where your moods can come under fire, either low mood or mood swings, both of which are commonly experienced often around that time of the month. B vitamins are found quite copiously in our diet. So again, lots of your nuts and seeds, there's a common trend here for these lovely fresh foods, but also all your lovely whole grains as well. They can be found there. So I hope that helps. And obviously this week we've been quite diet focused, which I hope's been useful to you. And next week we'll delve into some more symptoms. So if you enjoyed it, please subscribe to our channel and also be sure to hit the bell icon, and that means you'll be notified on any of our new topics. Bye!